आई गगनदीप बंसल लेक्चरर केमिस्ट्री फ्रॉम मेरिटोरियस स्कूल पटियाला वेलकम यू ऑल इन टूडेज केमिस्ट्री क्लास. इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर ऑफ द चैप्टर जनरल प्रिंसिपल्स एंड प्रोसेसेस ऑफ आइसोलेशन ऑफ एलिमेंट्स यू हैव स्टडीड अबाउट फर्स्ट टू प्रोसेसेस ऑफ आइसोलेशन ऑफ एलिमेंट. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू हैव कन्वर्टेड एन ओर इंटू इट्स ऑक्साइड. वी हैव कन्वर्टेड ओर इंटू इट्स ऑक्साइड्स बाय द प्रोसेस ऑफ कैल्सिनेशन एंड रोस्टिंग. कैल्सिनेशन एंड रोस्टिंग. नाउ वी हैव अ मेटल ओर इन टर्म्स ऑफ ऑक्साइड. सो इन टूडेज क्लास वी विल कन्वर्ट मेटल ऑक्साइड इंटू मेटल. सो वी हैव मेटल ऑक्साइड एंड टूडे वी विल कन्वर्ट दिस मेटल ऑक्साइड इंटू मेटल. सो मेटल ऑक्साइड इंटू मेटल. सो दैट इज वी हैव टू रिमूव ऑक्सीजन फ्रॉम द मेटल ऑक्साइड. एज यू नो रिमूवल ऑफ ऑक्सीजन दिस इज नोन एज अ रिडक्शन. सो अ मेटल ऑक्साइड कैन बी कन्वर्टेड इंटू मेटल बाय रिडक्शन एंड इन सम केसेस इट इज कन्वर्टेड बाय इलेक्ट्रोलिटिक रिडक्शन. इलेक्ट्रोलिटिक रिडक्शन. सो ए मेटल ऑक्साइड कैन बी कन्वर्टेड इंटू मेटल बाय रिडक्शन एंड इलेक्ट्रोलिटिक रिडक्शन. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल स्टडी अबाउट रिडक्शन. सो फर्स्ट प्रोसेस इज पायरो मेटलर्जी. पायरो मेटलर्जी. एज द नेम इंडिकेट्स पायरो इटसेल्फ मींस हीट. सो इट इज पायरो मींस हीट. सो कन्वर्जन ऑफ मेटल ऑक्साइड इंटू मेटल बाय हीटिंग इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ अ सुटेबल रिड्यूसिंग एजेंट इज कॉल्ड पायरो मेटलर्जी. सो कन्वर्जन ऑफ ए मेटल ऑक्साइड इंटू मेटल बाय हीटिंग इट इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ अ सुटेबल रिड्यूसिंग एजेंट इज कॉल्ड पायरो मेटलर्जी. सो नाउ सम मेटल्स दे रिड्यूस इजिली बट सम रिक्वायर हाई टेम्परेचर एंड सम रिड्यूसिंग एजेंट्स. सो सम मेटल्स मेटल ऑक्साइड्स दे आर कन्वर्टेड इन टू मेटल्स एट लो टेम्परेचर बट सम मेटल ऑक्साइड्स they are converted into metal they require a strong heating high temperature and they require a reducing agent and they require a reducing agent. We have a choice of different reducing agents. So choice of reducing agent this depends upon the nature of metal oxide and some thermodynamic parameters and some thermodynamic parameters. This we will study later in this chapter. So before going to the next I will discuss some details about reactivity series. So here we have arranged the metals in terms of their reactivity. The metals on the top of reactivity series they are highly reactive. So potassium, sodium, calcium, magnesium, aluminium, These metals are highly reactive metals. These metals, zinc, iron, lead, manganese, chromium, they are middle reactive. And the metals which are below hydrogen, copper, mercury, silver, gold, platinum, they are least reactive metals. So we have arranged the metals in terms of highly reactive, middle reactive and least reactive metal. First of all, we will study about least reactive metals. So least reactive metals, they undergo self-reduction, they undergo self-reduction or auto-reduction. They do not require a reducing agent. For example, mercury oxide, if we heat mercury oxide, it will be converted into mercury and oxygen. So this is auto reduction. Mercury oxide on heating is converted into mercury and oxygen. If we take copper glands, it will be converted into copper oxide plus sulfur dioxide. So on partial conversion, this copper oxide, this reacts with copper sulfide to form copper plus sulfur dioxide. So this is a self-reduction. So till now we have studied about pyrology, pyrometallurgy. Pyrometallurgy is conversion of a metal oxide into metal by heating in the presence of a suitable reducing agent. So in case of least reactive metals like copper, mercury, gold, they either undergo a self-reduction or auto-reduction. So they do not require a reducing agent. So there is no need of reducing agent in case of least reactive metals. For example, if we heat mercury oxide, so it will be converted into mercury, and same when copper glands, it is converted into copper oxide. On partial conversion, this copper oxide reacts with copper glands to form copper and sulfur dioxide. So next we will discuss about middle reactive metals. Middle reactive metals. So metals like zinc, iron, lead, manganese, chromium, they are middle reactive elements. They require a reducing agent. They require a reducing agent. If we have to convert a metal oxide of middle reactive metal, we need a reducing agent. So first of all, we will do reduction with carbon. Reduction with carbon. If we are converting a metal oxide into metal by using coke, चारकोल और एनी अदर फॉर्म ऑफ कार्बन, दिस प्रोसेस इज नोन एज अ स्मेल्टिंग. सो व्हाट इज स्मेल्टिंग? स्मेल्टिंग इज कन्वर्जन ऑफ मेटल ऑक्साइड इनटू मेटल बाय हीटिंग इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ कोक, कार्बन और चारकोल. सो दिस टर्म इज नोन एज अ स्मेल्टिंग. स्मेल्टिंग मीन्स यूज ऑफ कार्बन एज ए रिड्यूसिंग एजेंट. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इफ वी हीट जिंक ऑक्साइड विद कार्बन, इट विल बी कन्वर्टेड इंटू जिंक प्लस कार्बन मोनोऑक्साइड. वी कैन यूज कार्बन मोनोऑक्साइड, जिंक ऑक्साइड प्लस कार्बन मोनोऑक्साइड. इफ वी हीट दिस वी विल गेट जिंक प्लस कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड. इन केस ऑफ फेरिक ऑक्साइड इट विल बी कन्वर्टेड इंटू आयरन प्लस कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड. लेड ऑक्साइड प्लस कार्बन इट विल बी कन्वर्टेड इंटू लेड प्लस कार्बन मोनोऑक्साइड. All these reactions, they are known as smelting. So smelting is when we are reducing a metal oxide by using carbon as a reducing agent. This process is known as a smelting. Second, instead of carbon, we can use hydrogen as a reducing agent. So second is reduction with hydrogen. Here we are using hydrogen as a reducing agent. For example, if we take molybdenum oxide and we reduce it with hydrogen, it will be converted into molybdenum plus water. Same if we take tungsten oxide, it will be converted into tungsten plus water. If we take nickel oxide plus hydrogen, it will be converted into nickel plus water. So in these cases, in case of molybdenum, tungsten and nickel, we are using hydrogen as a reducing agent. But use of hydrogen as a reducing agent has a limitation that it is, as we know, hydrogen is very inflammable. So it is very expensive to do reduction with hydrogen. So this method is less preferred. Next we can use aluminium. So we will discuss reduction of middle reactive metals with aluminium. Reduction with aluminium. So in the first case, we have used carbon as a reducing agent. That process was a smelting. Then we have used hydrogen as a reducing agent. Now we are using aluminium as a reducing agent. This process is known as aluminotherapy. Using aluminium as a reducing agent. For example, if we take chromium oxide and we use aluminium as a reducing agent, it will be converted into chromium and aluminium oxide. Same if we take manganese oxide and we do reduction with help of aluminium, we will get manganese plus aluminium oxide. If we take ferric oxide and we do reduction with the aluminium, we will get iron plus aluminium oxide. Reduction with aluminium, it is a highly exothermic process. It is a highly exothermic process. That is, a lot of heat is evolved in this reaction. So, in this reaction, when we are doing reduction with the aluminium, we will get a liquid metal. We will get liquid chromium, liquid manganese, and liquid iron. So, reduction with aluminium, this is known as aluminotherapy. This reaction is a highly exothermic process. So, in this case, we are getting a metal in the molten form. Next, we are going to discuss one application of this aluminotherapy, that is a thermite welding. That is thermite welding. So this is an important application of aluminotherapy, thermite welding. It is used to weld railway tracks, and heavy machinery. What we do, in case there is a crack in the railway track, we take a crucible. With a hole at the bottom, we will take ferric oxide plus aluminium and we take magnesium ribbon. To ignite it, we take barium oxide. This mixture of ferric oxide plus aluminium, this is known as ferric thermite. This is known as ferric thermite. So this aluminium, as it is more reactive than iron, this will reduce iron. So ferric oxide will be converted into iron. So as it is a highly exothermic process, so we will get a molten form of iron which will cover this crack. So this process is known as thermite welding. So this is an important application of aluminotherapy, that is used to weld a railway tracks and heavy machinery. Next we will discuss reduction with more reactive metals. This least reactive metals, middle reactive metals, they can be reduced with reduction with more reactive metals. So here we are using more reactive metals like sodium or magnesium as a reducing agent. Certain metal halides like titanium tetrachloride, vanadium tetrachloride, they can be reduced with the help of a more reactive metals like sodium or magnesium. So it will be converted into titanium plus sodium chloride, vanadium plus sodium chloride. So in this case, we are using a more reactive metals as a reducing agent. So these metal halides, they can be converted into metal by using these reactive metals as reducing agent. Next, we can use water gas as a reducing agent. That's reduction with water gas. So as we know, water gas is a mixture of carbon monoxide plus hydrogen. So this can be used for the reduction. For example, if we take nickel oxide, so with the help of water gas, it will be converted into nickel plus carbon dioxide plus water. So, in this reaction, we have used water gas as a reducing agent. So, in case of middle reactive elements, we have used different reducing agents. In first case, we have used carbon. This process is known as smelting. In the next case, we have used hydrogen as a reducing agent. There is a one limitation with hydrogen, that it is highly inflammable. In the next case, we have used aluminium as a reducing agent. Next, we have used some more reactive metals like sodium, magnesium as reducing agents. And in the last, we have used water gas as a reducing agent. So next, we will do conversion of least reactive metal oxides into metals. So after middle reactive metals, we will discuss highly reactive metal oxides. So normal process of reduction cannot be used in case of highly reactive metal oxides because they themselves are very good reducing agents. So they cannot be reduced by simple reduction. In case of highly reactive metal oxides, we will use electrolytic reduction. Oxidation and reduction. For example, if we do electrolysis of molten NaCl, sodium ions, they will be reduced to sodium. And chlorine ions, they will oxidize to chlorine. So in this case, we are using oxidation as well as reduction. This reaction takes place at cathode, and this takes place as anode. So more reactive metals like sodium, they can be converted into their oxides by electrolytic reduction. We will take one more example of aluminium oxide. It will be converted into this is at cathode and this is at anode. So in case of highly reactive metals, they can be converted into metals by electrolytic reduction or oxidation reduction. So till now, we have discussed conversion of least reactive, middle reactive and highly reactive metal oxides into their metal. Now next, we will discuss thermodynamical effect of metallurgy. Principle of metallurgy. Thermodynamic principle of metallurgy. As you have seen, we have used different reducing agents. We have used carbon, aluminium, sodium, So twice of reducing agent, this will be determined by thermodynamics. As we know, according to Gibbs-Helmholtz equation, delta G naught equal to delta H naught minus T delta S. For a reaction to be spontaneous, delta G should be negative. So delta G should be negative. With this, we will discuss the role of a reducing agent. Role of a reducing agent. For example, if we do this reaction, ferric oxide smelting, it will be converted into iron plus oxygen. Experimental value of delta G is plus 40. So in this reaction, delta G is positive. So this is a non-spontaneous reaction. Though this is a non-spontaneous reaction. So according to principles of thermodynamics, this reaction is not feasible. Second case, carbon plus oxygen. This will be converted into carbon monoxide. In this case, value of delta G is minus 100. So this reaction is thermodynamically feasible. So this is a spontaneous reaction. So if we use carbon as a reducing agent for the conversion of this oxide into iron, so we will get iron plus carbon monoxide, and delta G value comes out to be minus 100 plus 40, that is minus 60. So delta G value of this reaction is negative. So this reaction is spontaneous. So in this case, this reducing agent, this has turned a non-spontaneous reaction into a spontaneous reaction. So today we have discussed about conversion of metal oxides into metal. So different type of metal oxides, like highly reactive, middle reactive and least reactive metals, they can be converted into metal oxides by different methods. Least reactive metals, they undergo self-reduction, whereas middle reactive metals, they require a reducing agent, whereas highly reactive metals, they can be converted by electrolytic reduction. And choice of reducing agents, it depends upon the thermodynamic parameters. So delta G should be negative for a reaction to be spontaneous. So I hope you have understood the lecture. Thanks. Gracias.